Hello students, in this video we will be learning Dev C++ software which can be used for programming in C and C++ languages. If you are new to the programming languages, then this video is important to you. If you have been using Turbo C++, then also this video is important. If you already know how to use Dev C++, then also it is important, because here we will be learning how to debug a program. So keep watching the video. So first of all, if you are new to the environment, important tools that we need to learn right away are, in the file menu we say new and we say source file. This opens a new file here. We can write our code here. The code that we will write today is for traversing an array, which belong, this topic comes under array operations. So again, in C, like in C language, we write hash include stdio.h, the include file, then hash include conio.h for using the getch function. Then we start with main. So in main, the last, since main is returning integer, so we will be returning integer in the end, and we want the program to wait for us to see the output, so we will use getch. Now what are the variables that we will be requiring? We want to traverse an array. That means there must be an array that can be traversed. So let us define an array of three elements. This software is adding the brackets. Once you put the starting bracket, ending bracket is automatically inserted, so you don't need to enter it. Similarly, we need an iterator variable using which we can index the array. Now we need for loop. The for loop will read the values from the user using the scanf statement. So we will print a friendly message for the user to understand what is happening. So we will say enter three numbers, and we put a semicolon here, and then we have say for int. Okay, int is already declared, so I is equal to 0, I less than 3. See, the array begins at 0 and there are 3 elements in the array, so we will iterate till less than 3, not equal to 3, it is less than 3. And then I plus plus, and within this loop what we will do is we will scanf percentage d, and very important step, we will write ampersand a of I, because our array name is a, index value is I, and ampersand is used for referring to this address. It is used with scanf. You already know C programming, so this ampersand is used with the as a language syntax. Now once we have read all the numbers, we want to print a message, friendly message to the user, that the numbers you entered are and again we use a for loop here and we write I is equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, and in this we say printf percentage d, and we will not use the ampersand and put a value of a of I in the printf. And finally we will come to the end of the program. So we can even write here in the end a printf statement, and we say end of program, press any key to continue. And we will put a couple of new lines. so that the program will look neat when it runs. Now the code is ready to be executed. Now we will go to the execute menu and click on compile. Okay, we did not save the code, so I am saving this file on the desktop as a C file here. Save as type is there. In this, multiple options are there. So this is a C source file. So I'll select this and let me name this program as traverse and array. In this, there is no limitation on the name of the file. Like in Turbo C, it has to be 8 characters. But here, no such limit is there. So we save. Okay, I already created the file. Okay, so there are a lot of errors. Okay, it's not a problem. I double type the bracket. And here also, we have double typed the bracket. So we go to execute, compile. Okay, so we are good to go. We don't have any errors. There's a okay, expected semicolon before get. We didn't put a semicolon over here. So let us put it. And it says that you don't need to put any extra spaces after include, so we'll remove them. So we go to execute, compile. Okay, good to go. It has compiled successfully. And okay, this symbol is extra. So again, we compile successfully. So we should not be afraid of the errors. Everybody gets errors. So only thing is, we should know how to read the error messages and remove those errors. That is important for a program. Now let us see the output of this program. So we click on execute and we say compile and run. Now the run window will appear. So here the message is there, enter three numbers. So I say 1, 2, 3, and then the numbers are printed, 1, 2, 3, and it says end of the program. Press any key to continue. So when I press a key, okay, the program has come to an end. Now, how to debug this program? Suppose there were logical errors in this program. How we are going to debug those logical errors? For this, we have a debug menu over here. Now, what we want to how we will debug is, we want to see the control flow, and we also want to see how the variables are changing in this program. So there are mainly two variables, a variable which happens to be an array, and there is a variable I which is the index variable. So we will include a add watch, and we will say that I want to monitor the symbol I and click on OK. And here you can see in the debug tab we are saying I, and we have to execute in order to find out what value it holds. Similarly, I will add a watch for each of the array elements. So A of 1, okay, A of 0 first. So A of 0, again add watch, I say A of 1, again add watch, and I say A of 2. Now the three watches have been added, and we can see here we won't need to execute these lines of code before these values. We can see how they are changing. Another thing we want to do is place toggle points where the execution will stop to reflect what is the value of each of these variables. So I put a toggle point here because here the array is getting modified. Now I will click on the debug button over here. So when I click on the debug button, my code is executing and I get this message, enter any three numbers. and the execution, you will see this line had become red. Now it is blue. That means the system is waiting for me to execute this line. So I click on next line and I go here and I give the input 1. I press enter. Now the control is going to the for loop. And here you can see the value of I is 0 and value of A of 0 is 1, and there is garbage in the other two variables. Now I click next line. Now I has become 1. Now I go here. I click on next line. I enter the next value over here, 2. I press enter again. The 2 value is added to A of 1 and I is still 1, and we are at the for loop. Again we click on next line. Now again the scanf is waiting to be executed. I click on next line. Now I go to the console. I enter the value 3 over here, and we can see that the third element is also updated in the array and the index value is 2. Now we click on next line. The index value tries to become 3 and the array, we have specified the condition I has to be less than 3. So the moment I becomes equal to 3, we are out of the loop. Now it is executing the printf statement. So we will click on next line. So it's saying numbers that you entered are, and then the for loop is getting executed, and we can see here how the value of I is changing and each of the values are printed on the output screen. So 1, 2, 3, all 3 of them are printed. Then next line. So end of program, it is asking you to press enter. So we will press a key over here. Okay. Press any key to continue. Okay, let us click continue here. And the program has ended and we could see the outputs. So this way we can debug a program and watch the variables in a program. Thank you.